cancer touched the heart of an entire community. 14-year-old Shelby Leonard's critical need for blood sparked the largest blood donation in this area since 9/11. While she ultimately lost her battle with cancer, Shelby won the hearts of the thousands of people who followed her story. And she continues to touch lives. As reporter Heath Allen tells us, one is a very special bond.
We were diagnosed with almost the same disease within weeks of each other.
17-year-old Harrison Bond was just beginning high school at Jesuit, a talented student athlete, when he was called out of his eighth grade class.
And I got a call from the office, says, Harrison Bond, please come to the office. So I'm like, oh no, what have I done?
But it was far worse than that. Harrison found out he had cancer. Within 24 hours, he'd already undergone his first round of chemotherapy.
And this is all coming from a normal kid.
From out of nowhere, cancer struck another normal kid, just like Shelby Leonard. Harrison didn't know Shelby, but suddenly they had much in common: cancer and a critical need for blood.
There's enough to deal with when you're dealing with a child with cancer. And the last thing you should have to worry about is, where is blood going to come from?
When Shelby fell ill, the blood was not there, and she needed a very special blood type. In fact, everything about Shelby was special. A 14-year-old student at the Academy of the Sacred Heart, a girl with a servant's soul, a brilliant smile, and a crush on the Beatles. Her courage and spirit mobilized this community. They rolled up their sleeves to give blood. Not since 9/11 had so many given so much.
Thank you, Heath. And if you're wondering, Harrison Bond, the young man you saw in Heath's story, is doing just fine. The 4th annual Shelby Leonard Memorial Blood Drive kicks off tomorrow morning at 7 and runs until 5. Donations will be taken in the Academy of the Sacred Heart Chapel. For all of the information on tomorrow's Shelby Leonard Blood Drive, just log on to our website at WDSU.com.